Hello everyone and welcome back to Genie Crafts. In today's video, we are going to see how we can create a layered unicolor silhouette portrait with a 3D effect. To create the template for this portrait, I'm going to visit one of my favorite websites, png2svg.com, which helps you divide your 2D image into layers. I have a very detailed tutorial on this website and this tool already on my channel, so you can click the card on the top or you can visit the layered art playlist on my channel. Either drag and drop the file for which you want to generate the template, or you can browse it on your system and select the file. Once you select, it will show you the palette of colors that it recognizes from the photo that you have provided. Also, since we are going to make a silhouette portrait, basically with a lot less details, but the details are getting captured in the different colored layers rather than the details on each layer itself. So for that, we are going to increase the simplicity level to the 10 and we are going to keep the colors to 5, because the more colors you go, the smaller the parts become and it becomes difficult to create gap between the layers with such small parts. If you are not creating the gap, you can increase the layers, because then you just need to paste one part on top of other. But here there will be a gap, so there will be some sort of sunboard sheet or foam sheet between the layers, and cutting that much small pieces of those foam sheets or sunboard sheets to create that gap becomes very challenging. So in short, keep the number of layers to 5. Click on generate button for software to create the template for you, and if you are happy with the template, you can download the SVG file, and you will need to take as many printouts as the total number of colors you have chosen before hitting on the generate button. So in our case, since we have 5 colors, we will need to take 5 printouts. To get the oval effect for the portrait, you can use online utilities, or you can also put this image into a Microsoft PowerPoint slide and superimpose the oval shape on top of it. As I mentioned in the beginning, this is going to be a unicolor silhouette portrait, which means I'm going to use different shades of the same color to achieve the layered effect. And in our case, I'm going to use different shades of gray. So we'll have the white as the brightest shade and we'll have the black as the darkest shade with different shades in between. So to start cutting out the layers, attach the template on top of the 5 colored paper that we are going to use for this portrait. Also, there is no particular sequence to the colors. It's up to you how you want the sequence. If you want the white to come out most, then white should be the last layer. If you want the black to come out most, then black should be the last layer, or any other color, whichever you want. So that's up to you how you want to do it. I'm going to go by the sequence of the shade, so black will be the bottommost layer and white will be the topmost layer in my case. I forgot to mention one thing, that the thickness of the paper that you are going to use for this portrait should be at least 200 GSM, which means that ideally you should not be using a A11 blade to cut the layers. I am using the A11 blade here mostly for recording purposes, but had I not been recording, then I would have used a shorter blade. So if you have a shorter blade, utilize that to cut the layers. The bottommost layer is the base layer and is normally the outline of your portrait shape, which in this case is this oval. So I'm going to quickly cut out this oval to get my base layer ready. Now we move on to the second layer. So first, identify the areas which are represented by the color for the second layer. Now within those areas, if you see colors which are also represented by the layers that you have already cut. So since we have already cut the black base before this layer, so if we find any areas which are represented by the black color within the borders of the layer which we are cutting, then in that case we need to remove that first. So within the areas of the gray color on the portrait, I am first going to remove the black portions, and then I will cut out the gray areas, and that will become my second layer. The same rule follows for the next layer. So suppose the next layer is white, so within the white, if I see any portions which are black or gray, then in that case I will first need to remove it and then cut out the areas for the white portions. Follow the same rule for all the layers. Once you have cut all the pieces for that particular layer, loosely assemble it to see if you have got it right. And after that, now we will start creating the gap between the layers to give it the 3D effect. To create the gap between the layers, I am going to use this 3mm thick sunboard sheets, which will not only help the portrait layers stabilize, but also create sufficient gap between the layers. cut out small squares of the sunboard sheet and place it all over on the opposite side of the layer. Make sure that they are spread across the layer to give it sufficient support. Once you have pieces glued on one side on the layer, apply glue on the other side of the pieces and assemble it on the bottom layer. For proper alignment of the pieces, you can always take reference from the layer that you have just cut, or you can also have the SVG file open in front of you and take reference from that. Just ensure that the pieces are aligned properly and going at the places where they are supposed to go, otherwise the effect of the portrait gets distorted and you might end up with something which is not like the portrait you wanted. If the extremely small pieces are very difficult for you to handle, you can always leave it, because you can only cut so much small pieces of sunboard sheet to stick between the two layers. And that's why I mentioned at the very beginning that you need to restrict the number of layers that you want for the portrait. The more the number of layers, the more difficult it becomes to create gap between the layers. So if you're not able to, leave it. Similarly, work your way to the top layer of the portrait and with each layer create the gap between them with the help of the sunboard sheets. Just ensure that those pieces are not sticking out from underneath the layer, because that would not look good on the portrait. One of the best thing about this portrait is that it does not need a frame at all, because this oval shape in itself is a frame and it looks really beautiful on the wall. And the 3D effect has also come out really good because of the 3mm gap between all the layers. If you guys like this tutorial, then please do not forget to hit the like button and do share it with your friends. Also subscribe to my channel for regular videos on paper arts. I will see you guys very soon in my next video. Till then, stay safe, take care, and bye bye.